After victory in three crucial states in the Hindi heartland, the Congress is now faced with the dilemma of choosing its chief ministerial candidate in the states of Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. The suspense escalates as the MLAs have left it to Congress President Rahul Gandhi to decide on the post for all the three states.
मुख्यमंत्री बनाने के लिए ना मध्य प्रदेश में ना छत्तीसगढ़ में और ना राजस्थान में ना कोई शक है ना शंका है ना शुभा है. कांग्रेस अध्यक्ष श्री राहुल गांधी ने ये निर्देश दिया था कि कांग्रेस के शीर्षतम नेतागण, वो चाहे श्री ए.के. एंटनी जी हों जो मध्य प्रदेश गए हैं, जो छत्तीसगढ़ गए हैं वो खड़गे साहब हों, और चाहे के.सी. वेणुगोपाल जी हों जो राजस्थान गए हैं, वो और महासचिवगण एक एक विधायक की अलग अलग राय जान लें ताकि निर्वाचित विधायकों की राय को पूरी तरजीह दी जा सके. कांग्रेस के कार्यकर्ताओं की राय भी हमने गुप्त तौर से जानने का प्रयास किया है. इसके पीछे केवल एक भाव है.
Now in Rajasthan, the suspense over the chief minister's post persists. Congress Legislative Council went into an 8-hour long huddle, but no conclusive decision came of it. Meanwhile, Ashok Gehlot and Sachin Pilot have now reached Delhi to meet Congress President Rahul Gandhi, who will take the final call on who becomes Rajasthan's next chief minister.
अब सबकी राय ले ली है पर्यवेक्षकों ने बहुत ही शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से. और क्योंकि एक प्रस्ताव पास किया गया था कि राहुल गांधी जी पर जो हमारे माननीय अध्यक्ष है कांग्रेस के वो निर्णय करेंगे, तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग टू हमारे पर्यवेक्षक जो हैं वो दिल्ली आ गए हैं. और आज मैं समझता हूँ चर्चा होकर आज फैसला हो जाएगा. अब जो मैं आया हूँ तो हमें बुलाया गया तो नेचुरल है कि मीटिंग होगी.
Right, let's remember this has in fact been a bone of contention in Rajasthan yesterday. There were droves and scores of supporters that we saw gathered at the Congress headquarters in the state, each chanting for the leader that they support, be it Ashok Gehlot or Sachin Pilot. Let's remember that this is in fact a kind of factionalism that the Congress party cannot afford at this time. But all questions and all eyes on Rajasthan and of course the two other states on who is going to be the next chief minister. Is it going to be Sachin Pilot, the ex-minister of corporate affairs in the UPA 2 government and a two-time MP? Is it going to be him who ran Congress's grassroots campaign in the state? It remains to be seen. My colleague Meenakshi Bhanja now joining me live from the capital. Meenakshi, give us all the details.
Well, Sanjana, this is going to be a hugely interesting one. And of course, as is tradition and protocol within the Congress party, the chief ministerial candidate is not announced before or ahead of the elections. So therefore, we saw that play out even during this time. And indeed, you know, it does not serve any parties. It is not advantageous, or it does not serve to the benefit of any party if the leaders are at cross purposes with each other. And therefore, in the run-up to Rajasthan in particular, we have seen how Ashok Gehlot and Sachin Pilot both have worked neck to neck for the resurgence of the Congress in particularly Rajasthan. We also know that both the leaders are in Delhi as we speak, and there is this critical meet which is underway where the observers of Rajasthan are likely to be briefing Rahul Gandhi about what they have assessed from the members of the legislature, from the MLAs that they have actually spoken to. And also remember this, Rahul, a Congress president, is trying to really assimilate all the wishes of all the people, and therefore we are seeing several other methodology also be adopted by the Congress High Command. We have heard from Randeep Surjewala with regards to this. And going forward, what will be critical and why this is a tough choice is simply because of this, Sanjana, that Congress in Rajasthan has particularly managed to really gather or amass all the numbers by its own virtue, and therefore it really does not go ahead and require the support of any outside party to form government. It can form government by its own dint of merit. So therefore both Sachin Pilot and Ashok Gehlot at this point in time are equal and strong contenders for the post of Chief Minister Rajasthan. One hand, Ashok Gehlot is a long time old Congress person who's supposed to be a tall leader at the grassroots level.
Right.
But again, the supporters of Sachin Pilot are of the point of view that it is Sachin Pilot who is credited with the resurgence of Congress party, particularly after the debacle that it witnessed in the earlier assembly elections results. And therefore, Sachin Pilot's claim at Chief Minister post Rajasthan cannot be brushed aside or be disregarded in a light manner.
Absolutely. Meenakshi, thank you so much for bringing us those updates. We'll continue tracking the latest from the national capital. Let's remember where Sachin Pilot and Ashok Gehlot have in fact landed and will be meeting Congress President Rahul Gandhi. Over to Madhya Pradesh now, where the Congress wasted no time in staking claim to form the government in the state after both Mayawati and Akhilesh Yadav offered support to the party. But now the bigger concern is who to pick for the top spot. My colleague Mandar Fansena joining me live from Bhopal, who's been tracking the story and the elections very closely. Mandar, after initial jostling in the camps of both Jyotiraditya Scindia and Kamal Nath, sources are in fact telling Mirror now that Kamal Nath is likely to be sworn in as Chief Minister. But again, both the top contenders will be meeting Congress President Rahul Gandhi in the national capital today.
Absolutely. Now it's all upon Mr. Rahul Gandhi, the Congress president, who would decide, citing the feedback from the MLAs as well as the feedback from his party cadre. Remember, Mr. Rahul Gandhi has floated an app where he has also loaded that particular audio where he is appealing the Congress party cadre to just tell their opinion about their own same. That shows how close this particular issue for the Congress is all about. Congress is still trying to take the pulse of the situation even more closely on the ground. And as far as Madhya Pradesh is concerned, the situation in Madhya Pradesh will be very, very difficult than what Rajasthan is all about, because Madhya Pradesh needs a more mature, seasoned kind of a leader. That's what is the feedback from most of the Congress workers with whom we were speaking yesterday. It was also noticed that there was no one-upmanship or no show of any display of power between the two camps of Jyotiraditya Scindia or, for that matter, Mr. Kamal Nath. Of course, the presence of Kamal Nath supporters were more yesterday on the streets ahead of the Congress House. But more to that, comparing to Kamal Nath and Jyotiraditya, most of the people, especially the young crowd from all over Madhya Pradesh, was insisting on Jyotiraditya Scindia's name, while the senior party cadres were saying that this will be very difficult to run this particular state in a situation where there is a formidable opponent in BJP having those many numbers as equal as Congress, and therefore it will be very difficult to run the state, and for that you need a person like Kamal Nath. Of course, the overall situation where the support of the MLAs is concerned, both the leaders are equally strong and equally getting the support. We come to know from some sources that even around 70 MLAs have gone personally and met Mr. Jyotiraditya Scindia as well at his hotel. Apart from that, again, remember Jyotiraditya Scindia's clout is in the north of Madhya Pradesh till the Malwa Nimad region, and in the Mahakaushal area of Madhya Pradesh, Kamal Nath's clout is also there. Both these areas, especially Mahakaushal, Nimad and Malwa, and at the same time Chambal region along with Bundelkhand, has fared well for Congress barring Vindhyanchal. So these all areas basically have contributed equally to the kitty of the Congress as far as both the leaders are also concerned. And and one more factor which is invisible in this election is Digvijay Singh. Mr. Digvijay Singh's cadre and his connect across the Madhya Pradesh is also one thing which is very influential and which is very important. While The MLAs who have been elected are also from the camp of Digvijay Singh. And remember, this particular group of MLAs also will matter a lot while taking this particular decision between the two. But as of now, taking a overall situation and the sources what we are talking about are very confident that Kamal Nath will be the final choice for Congress.
Right, Mandar, thank you so much for putting that in perspective. We'll continue tracking all the latest developments coming out of Bhopal and the national capital. Meanwhile, Congress President Rahul Gandhi, through an audio message, appealed to 7.3 lakh party workers of Chhattisgarh, MP and Rajasthan to respond with their choice of chief minister. Promising confidentiality, the message asked workers to indicate their choice. Rahul also congratulated the leaders on the party's victory in the heartland states.
नमस्कार, मैं राहुल गांधी बोल रहा हूँ. विधानसभा चुनाव जीतने पर कांग्रेस के सब कार्यकर्ताओं को, सब नेताओं को बहुत बहुत बधाई. आप पोलिंग बूथ पे खड़े हुए, आपने कांग्रेस पार्टी की विचारधारा की लड़ाई लड़ी और आप जीते. इसके लिए आप सबको दिल से मैं धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ. अब मैं आपसे एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण सवाल पूछना चाहता हूँ. आप मुझे बताएं, हमारा मुख्यमंत्री कौन होना चाहिए? कृपया सिर्फ एक नाम बताइए. आप जो नाम बताएंगे वो सिर्फ मुझे पता होगा, पार्टी में किसी भी और को नहीं पता लगेगा. अभी आपको एक बीप सुनाई देगी, उस बीप के बाद आप जिसे मुख्यमंत्री बनाना चाहते हैं उनका नाम कह दीजिए.